Welcome, everybody. Today I'm going to be doing Easter, probably a bunny, and I'm just going to incorporate it into the background of this jelly print page. And I'm going to be using the Golden's shading gray in it's transparent, and it is the high flow acrylic. Well, you never know. Just some practice, that's all. Let's get a paintbrush. What am I going to use? Just the one around. To use the filbert. With all these paintbrushes, you'd think I'd find one. No. Don't want to use my good ones. So. Gotta be one somewhere. Let me check this spot. Oh, here's a cheapie. I can use the bigger one if I want. It's got some flared hairs though. Nope, that's not good. I'm picky, picky. Gotta find just the right brush. I don't like brushes with flared hairs. Where's my roll? You know I got good ones in there. Oh, that one will do. It's a cheapie. I think. Oh, that'll do. Here. Found one. So it can't be too stiff or it doesn't work as good. So, we'll put some shading in his ear first. Before it dries, I want to I don't like a real hard edge. And then I can go back over this with marker or whatever. And you don't need a lot. Let's see. Get a little bit in there. Do you want me to? You may not be able to see a lot of that what I'm doing here. Do you want me to zoom in again? big ears. They usually do have huge ears, that type of rabbit, whatever you want to call them. You can always go back over it too if you want to darken it. Trying to find my marks I made. Where did I put it? Nose. His eyes. Right about here. It's oval because it's their eyes are kind of on the side of their head. Cass, can you turn the sound up a bit? Yep. Can. How's that? Too loud? That better? Sorry, Ange. Oh, that's better. Okay. So you could do this also with ink. Just dip your brush in ink. Where did I have this body end? Can't see my drawing. You like them? They're fun to do. I like bunnies. Still a little bit wet. Let's see what else we can do up here. Some more color in there. Out. More in here. CB. Okay, let's dry that. Heat gun. Now, I think I will take, see, are these permanent? Brush, flexible, excellent bounce, easier, easily achieved, archival, pigment ink, it's waterproof and fade resistant on fine paper. Don't know if this will work, but we're gonna try it. It's fine. Oh, they're both fine. I want something bigger. Need a black marker. They must be all upstairs, most of them. Oh, there's a brush marker. That's brown. I don't want brown. It's this one. Fine. Okay. This is just a brush marker from I think it's a Micron. Sakura Micron. So I just want to use it for the darker areas. Because you can play with the thickness a little bit. Darkness of his eye should be nice and dark. His little mouth. Then take my favorite Castel, I think. Should be able to do fine lines fairly. Can smudge them too, which is nice. Oh, they're still not quite as thin as I would like. Let's see. I'll try this. She does have. There we go. Nice. From the nose. Put some specks in here where the fur is. It's a little bit of a fuzzy guy. Just very light touch. Even though this is a fine marker, just a light wisp, then you don't have that big globby thing on the end. dots. More of a concentration of fur on the edges and gives it a little more dimension in. Those cheeks need some too. Now his ears. Hey, Zandra. A little bit of fur in the ear, inside of the ear here. A little bit fuzzy. Right here. And along the edge. Do some sketchy lines just to indicate where the outer edge is. Okay, he needs a little bit of definition where his eyeball is. A little bit darker in here, I think. Okay, I'm gonna dry this ink up. So, heat gun, Marilyn. Thanks, Ella. All right, now, where's my pen? Is that it? Is that my good one? Don't think so. Where did I put my pen? Lose that. My favorite pen now. A little accent. Put a little bit of white in here. And here, give it a little more definition with the white. It makes it stand out a little bit more. Kind of highlights his little fur. Just a little bit on her chest. Awesome pen. There. efficient market. 217. There's my bunny. Big ears. Well, that's just with the shading gray on jelly paper. Thanks, guys. That was cute. Next. Let's do Where's my pencil? There it is. What could we do? I haven't got any photographs down here, I don't think. Thanks, Ange. Oh, magazine. Somewhere. Do a face or something, but I don't think I have any magazines down here anymore. Well, I could just wing it. Don't know who this is going to be, but we'll just draw somebody, a face of some sort. And then I'll have to use white or something to get rid of some of the weird colors. Can't see. Get her eyebrows. I don't know if her chin's too big. I'm having a hard time seeing here. But let's give her a do. Curly hair. Long. Chin will be there, and neck probably there. And shoulder. Hey, Jillian. I'm just playing. Not sure how these are going to turn out. We're just going to play. Let's see. I guess we'll... Let's put her eyes right here. Her eyebrow. Nose. Might have to change that chin up a bit because it's a little bit on the nose will be a bit darker. In your chin. That dry a bit. Hey, Margaret. Okay, let's try that. So heat gun. Now I'm going to use a little bit of titanium white fluid from Golden just to do some highlights to get rid of some of this red. Then I can always put more dark colors in. The fluid's usually fairly transparent anyways, so it's just gonna that eye's kind of looking scary. That dry. Heat gun. Had a bad day. Yeah, let's give that under her eye there is not looking the best. So we'll clean that up a bit. Right here. Gun. Do that a few times. I think I'm gonna put the black on first. So she's looking kind of to the side. I'm going to bring her lid down more. That looks like a, I'll wipe that out. That was part of the writing here. Makes her look like her. Her lips way over. Wipe that out. And she looks like she has pink eye. Okay, I'm gonna eat gun. Her eye up. Guess we can give the top lip a little bit more color, because the top lip is usually darker. And darken it around there a little bit. Just the suggestion that she has clothes on. There. And let's color some of her hair. We'll just shade it in a little bit so the first marks that I put down will still stay darker. That's the nice thing about these golden high flows. It's when it's almost like a glaze that you can put over top. More. Thanks, Evie. I just sprayed it and it went all over the place. Luckily, it didn't come out too much. Oop, she's got a mole. A little bit darker in here. So it'd be the underside of her hair. Suppose I could use the marker too. Since it's so close to her face. She's in serious thought. Yep. Sounds good. I don't know who she is, but I winged it. Let that dry. Heat gun. All right. Like she needs a little bit of a shadow on the side of her face because her hair would be shadowing her face. But not too much. That side of her face would be shadowed. Put a little more of a cheekbone in here. Probably don't even notice it. It's so faint. But it does make a difference. Really. Alright, let's put she needs a wait a minute. Gotta dry it again, guys. All right, pen. Hope this is. I need a really bright white, but I don't know. It's not really bright enough. I need a really. It's a little bit on the transparent side. So, where's my? If you really need a really bright white, I always like using the Sharpie instead of acrylic paint. I like it to be very precise. So, just a dot. And let's put some highlights in her hair, I guess. What else? There. A quick sketch on your Gelli paper. Oh, thanks, Jen. Thanks, everybody. So we just play. See, I like to do it on this. I used to do these quite a few years ago on top of backgrounds or scrapbook paper, and then I just use either charcoal or white charcoal to do the highlights and shadows, and it looks really cool. Kind of looks mysterious. Did I miss it? Ah, good. Give it a nice shade. Okay, that is so weird. I've never heard of that, Ange. That was weird. Yeah, check it out. My brother goes to the state all the time. He's never mentioned it about having to show. Is it? Well, I imagine it would be for everyone, wouldn't it? Just not like that. It would seem weird. Okay. it wasn't. I guess because your colors are already pre-made for the color of the glass that's there. So you're not making the color of the glass. You're using. Mind you have to have a kerbillion samples of glass, but okay, so we'll put some. Heat gun. Makes sense. So you taught yourself color art. Yeah, basically, taught myself color. Okay, so what should I do with it? Let's put some, where's that pen? Put it darker. So. Then gun. Right, what else can I do with this guy? Oh, I know. Let's put. Crack there. And how am I going to do this? Okay, I gotta keep going. Beacon. Done. Where did I put that brush? I love these pens. Just saying. Here, Ella. The little chick. You like them? It's kind of a big egg for a little guy. Maybe there's triplets in there. All night, Laura. egg. Yeah, I couldn't have just an egg. Had to do something. Make it darker in there. It's dark in there. Sticking his head out. Let's see what's going on. Scrawny little. Thanks, guys. Oh, curly chickens? Oh, those are cool. I've seen those. They're awesome. And they don't smell? Let's put some curls on them. Oh, wrong one. There. Some curls. Those were cute. The bunny. I just lost my bunny. Where'd he go? So many papers. Sheesh. Don't know where I put my bunny. There you go. Oh, there he is. Little girl, Easter egg, and bunny. Thanks, guys. There. Really can't even see the face of a chick. Oh, cool. I think they turned out cool. Yeah, I'll be awake. The bunny's your favorite? Yeah. I love bunnies. They're cute. Thanks, Jen. Thanks, everyone. So I'll let you guys go and you all have a fantastic evening, and tomorrow we'll probably see you at Dee Dee's. I know I'm working from home, so I might pop in. So you all have a good night, and we'll see you next week. I don't know what I'm going to do, but you never know. You're welcome. Night, everyone.